What makes it almost impossible to challenge this is when you have, well, okay, let's take the contrast then, right? If you have a website with one product on it, okay, is it even worthwhile for this traveler to go through the very expensive and laborious process of trying to find your website somewhere there in the millions, tens of millions of websites representing individual properties somewhere on the internet? Or are they better off just going through this particular system, this network effect? So the reason I'm deciding to include this tangential episode on the Bali Business Review is because I think fundamentally the idea of AI has been, it's been misconstrued, it's been misrepresented, and I feel that, and I know that if people don't understand the fundamentals, then they're probably going to get sidelined, mistracked, and also you'll get people who eventually will start talking nonsense, gaining space in conversations that they probably should avoid. And that risk, I think, is something that will, I think it will contaminate the development of Bali. I think it will lead to a situation where there's just going to be more knowledge pollution. And, you know, when you have knowledge pollution combined with artificial intelligence, you get pretty much the worst of everything. We're going to go on campus to give a guest lecture. And the lecture we're going to talk about is in particular on a subject that... Oh, hey there. How's it going? What's your name?
My name's KK.
Katie what?
Kappa Delta Kappa.
Amazing. Okay, Katie K. So that happens to be my daughter, by the way. So we're going to go on campus today to talk about entrepreneurship in Indonesia. So graduated from this university almost, 20 years ago. And so coming back here has special nostalgic feelings, especially since I'm getting to kind of talk about, I guess, my life's work so far. Hopefully it fills up more than just a few episodes. But in the meantime, let's talk about what is something on the kind of minds of everybody these days, which is the influx of AI and its, I don't know, its effect on all industries. And so I think if you really want to understand artificial intelligence, then you begin with foundations, and the foundations are in computer science, they're in data science. And this is a discipline that is practiced very rigorously and correctly here at the University of California at Berkeley. So what we're going to try to attempt to do is to get to the fundamentals of how AI and its different manifestations in the modern world can actually be understood better by just gaining some strong understanding on a few key concepts here.
Well, it looks like I got this lecture hall all to myself, and I'll probably make good use of it today to try to explain a few concepts that elude most people here. So let me see if I can get my materials ready. Ooh, practice for lecture is always so daunting, especially when you're facing an empty room right now. Anyways, all kidding aside, let's go over a few basic concepts that maybe the first thing I'd like to talk about is this idea of, well, where are you better off actually getting your bookings from? Your own website or a travel platform? So I'll make the argument that the way that most travel platforms work, it's so all-encompassing, it's so inertia-building that it becomes almost an impossible task to challenge that with an individual website. So the first concept I'd like to talk about using this trusty piece of chalk here, is an idea called network effects. Network effects. So what drives network effect? What exactly does it mean? Network effects, essentially, is the balance of a two-sided marketplace. So on one side, you have the supply, and the other side, you have demand. So the way a marketplace works in Bali is, let's say, for example, somebody offers their villa on the supply side. Well, then there's a connection then to, I guess, a traveler, to one traveler representing one unit of demand on the opposite side of the marketplace. But now this is all well and good. This is a very simplified version of a marketplace. But what happens if you add more supply? Well, as soon as you add more supply, now this traveler has two options as well. But that creates a more efficient marketplace because this person now has two options that they can find. What if there's three? Well, then that's even better. There's three options now that this traveler can find. What if there's four? And as you can see, this gets better. As the supply side gets more enriched with more supply, what happens over here is that more travelers also find more utility in this marketplace, meaning that more travelers will start accumulating over on this side of the marketplace because there's more options that they'll be able to find. Well, the people on The supply side noticed that there's going to be more and more demand building up. So what happens is that more supply starts building up. You see? So network effects eventually do this, that more demand start driving more supply, and more supply start driving more demand. So this constant positive reinforcement cycle, we call this a positive reinforcement. This positive reinforcement cycle is the holy grail of most marketplaces. If you think about how a lot of internet businesses work, they over time become a monopoly. If you're talking about understanding your social graph and your social networks, it's probably all within the realm of Facebook, meaning WhatsApp, Instagram, and of course the classic Facebook. If you're talking about, well, shoring repositories for long format videos, or let's say landscape format videos, then it's all under YouTube. If you're talking about vacation rental, it's all Airbnb. If you're talking about hotels, it's probably all booking.com. So this is the idea of a network effect. And so what makes it almost impossible to challenge this is when you have, well, okay, let's take the contrast then, right? If you have a website with one product on it, okay, is it even worthwhile for this traveler to go through the very expensive and laborious process of trying to find your website somewhere there in the millions, tens of millions of websites representing individual properties somewhere on the internet? Or are they better off just going through this particular system, this network effect? So added on top, the network effect is then secured in place by a lot of, I would say, that facilitate transactions on the marketplace. Things like cancellation policies, market quality control. What else? What else is there? I remember. Accepting international payments, and of course, reliable customer service. Okay, so the bulk of what an online travel marketplace is doing is it's extending the powers of the network effect through, I guess, bespoke services, maybe not bespoke services, but just facilitating transaction by adding all of these features on top of it. So platforms like Amazon, platforms like Airbnb, platforms like Booking.com, Traveloka, they all include these particular features. And that's a way for basically this lock-in effect. So ultimately, the reason that the travel platform tends to win is because they really think about this. It's called CLTV. It means customer lifetime value. So the objective of a travel booking platform or an e-application is to get into a mechanic, into a mechanism in which the user is, once they think, I need to fulfill this particular need, right? Like I need to go travel, or I need to go buy something, or I need to find a ride, they reach automatically for that application. And after the process of that has been repeated, a few dozen times, it becomes almost like a mechanic. It becomes an instinct for them to do that. And thus the platform has achieved customer lifetime value, because whenever the trigger for that need occurs, they just reach for the app and they just book. And so this customer lifetime value is facilitated also by really good UI UX design. Okay. And also frequent updates. And usually some loyalty points. Okay. So this is generally called app lock-in. The more the application can, I would say, use the mechanisms of a game to get the user to reopen that time after time after time, the app wins. Now, this is an interesting question, because if users today are favoring experiences, right, how often are they going to open an application or go to a website in which the actual product is only sold once, and there's only one particular type of option they might find, versus one where they find hundreds, millions, unlimited number of options that keep on replenishing as well, which is also another key feature. The problem also with trying to sell, I would say, short-term rentals using this system here, which is woefully behind, is that even if there is a, let's say, a loyalty between this particular person and your particular property, the end product that they're booking is not, it's not your actual accommodation. It's the end product they're going to be booking is a date on a calendar, right? Say, for example, December, block of dates from 15th to 20th. Okay, so this block of dates is what this person over here is actually buying from you. But then what are the chances that at the same time that they want to actually book. Let's say they want to make travel plans a month earlier, so they're coming in on November 11th. What are the chances that on November 11th, this block is still available year after year after year? You see, the real product that most travelers actually want is they want a block of dates on somebody's calendar to secure their accommodation. So if your block of dates, well, is not available, then they're going to look for availability once again in a larger marketplace where there's more availability. Hopefully this simple explanation of how network effects drive the, let's say, growth of online marketplaces through the accumulation and that's kind of a snowball effect or positive reinforcement makes sense. And it also allows one to then gain intuition on how to solve the particular problem, how to use AI to once again boost your particular positioning, not in the global marketplace into, you know, wherever somebody can make a booking, but specifically into targeting the most popular online travel platforms such that it's a better use of your time.